Welcome to all my BIM students. In the revision class, I am solving some problems in complex number. After that, I will solve the question sent by Prashant. Thank you, Prashant. Representation of a complex number in polar form. Wait. Z equal to x plus iy, we are complex number. First we represent this number Cartesian with respect to x and y axis. It is also called Argand diagram. It is named after the mathematician Argand. Draw perpendicular PM on x-axis and join the points OP. This distance is denoted by R. This distance is X. This distance is Y. OPM cos theta is equal to x square or x equal to r cos theta. Sin theta is equal to or y is equal to r sine theta. Now z equal to x plus iy r cos theta plus ir sin theta. It is a polar representation. Now, x square plus y square equal to r square cos square theta plus r square into 1. R equal to root under x square plus y square. It is called modulus of z. That is, z equals to mod z equals to. And dividing r sine theta upon r cos theta is equal to y by x. Tan theta is equal to y by theta is equal to theta is called amplitude or argument of z. In abbreviated form, theta is equal to r z or m. To find a square root of a complex number. Let z equal to x plus iy be a complex number. Then each square root must be plus minus root under a plus ib. Plus minus a plus ib. Squaring both sides, we get x plus iy equals to equating real and imaginary parts, we get a square minus b square equal to x. Two ab equals to now a square plus b square whole square equal to a square minus b square whole square plus 4 a square b square. Now putting the value of this, we have now adding 3 and 4, we get two a square is equal to root under x square plus y square plus x upon 2. Therefore, a equals to root under subtracting equation 2, so 2 and 4, equation 2 from 4, we get 2b square equal to minus x. B square equal to therefore x square plus y square minus x by 2. Putting these values of a and b in equation 1, we will get the required root. Putting the values of A and B in equation 1, we get the required root. Also, we have to remember that if xy is positive, then there is no need to change the sign any of the A and B. If xy is negative, then there must be change the sign any one of the A and B. It means if xy is negative, then either we change the sign of A or the change of sign of B. If it is positive, then we make it negative. If it is positive, then it is made negative. Any one of either A or of B. Change the sign any one of them, either of A or of B, not of both. Find the cube root of unity. We can find the cube root of unity by algebraic method or by using De Morgan's theorem. First, we find the cube root of unity by algebraic method. Let z equals to cubic root of 1. Then cubic both sides, we get z cube equal to 1, or z cube minus 1 equal to 0, or z minus 1 into z square plus z plus 1 equal to 0. Therefore, either z minus 1 equal to 0 or z square plus z plus 1 equal to 0. From 1, z equal to 1, which is real, From So using quadratic formula, z is equal to minus b plus minus b squared minus 4ac upon 2a. Here, coefficient of z squared is 1, coefficient of z is 1 is considered 1. Minus 1 plus minus root under minus 1 plus minus I root 3 by 2. Therefore, cube roots of unity are 1, 1 is real and other two are imaginary. Properties. Number one, imaginary cube roots, cube root of imaginary cube roots are a square of each other. It means it is a square of this or it is a square of this. Then let minus 1 plus I root 3 by 2 equal to omega. Then omega square equal to whole square. Now, in the numerator, it is in the form a minus a. So we have minus 1 square, I root 3 square, 4 into 1 into I root 3 upon 4. 1 plus 3i square minus 2 root 3i upon 4. 1 minus 3, 3 equals to minus 2, minus 2 root 3i upon 2. Taking common 2 from numerator. Minus 1. Minus I root 3 upon 2. Cancel. Similarly, let minus 1 minus I root 3 by 2 is equal to omega. Then, by squaring, we have its result will be minus 1 plus I root 3 by 2. So, the square of this will be this, and the square of this will be this. satisfying the statement immediately two roots of unit A, cube roots of cube roots are square of each other. Cube roots of unity or unity are square of each other. Number two, sum of the cube roots of unity is zero. Sum of the cube roots of unity is zero. One plus omega plus minus one plus I root 3/2 taking LCM minus 1 plus I root 3 minus 1 minus I root cancel out 1 minus 2/2 1 minus 1 equal to 0. Product of two imaginary cube roots is equal to real root. See here. Omega into omega square is equal to I root 3/2 into by 2 minus 1 square upon one plus three, 4/2. That is omega cube equal to 1. It is one of the properties. Now, a statement of the De Maeve's theorem. Cos n theta plus I sin n theta is one of the values of cos theta plus I sin theta power 1. Cos n theta plus I sin n theta is one of the values of cos theta plus I sin theta whole power n. Statement of De Maeve's theorem. Cos n theta plus I sin n theta is one of the value of cos theta plus I sin theta whole power n. N is a positive, negative, or fractional integer. It is true for all either all positive integer or all negative integer or fractional integer. All are true. Another statement is here in terms of R. Cos theta whole power n equal to R power n cos n theta plus I sin n theta. Nth root of a complex number. Cos theta plus I sin theta whole power cos 2 pi r plus theta I sin 2 pi r plus theta whole power 1 by cos 2 pi r plus theta upon n I sin theta upon n r equal to 0, 1, 2 up to n minus 1. After when we take the value n greater than minus 1 means n, n will give the same result of 0. N plus 1 will give the result of 1. N plus 2 will give the result of 2. So there are only n roots. 0 to n minus 1 equal to n roots. If in the examination it is asked that find the two roots of unity by using the Mapper theorem, then you must find the root by using the Mapper theorem. Otherwise, you will not get the marks. You will not get the mass. There will be zero mass. So if method is mentioned, then you must find the root by using that method. If it is not mentioned in your question, then you may find any of the two methods. Now, I am finding the roots by using the Mapper theorem, two roots of unity. find the cube root of unity by using Bimawa theorem. Let z equal to 1 power 1 by 3. These two roots, one can be written as cos 0 plus I sin 0. Cos 0 plus I sin 0. Cos 0 will be 1, sin 0 will be 0. So it will be 1. Now, cos 2 pi r plus 0 plus I sin 2 pi r plus 0 means cos 2 pi r plus I sin 2 pi r. Now putting this value forward, we have cos 2 pi r plus I sin 2 pi r whole power 1 by 3, r equal to 0, 1, 2. Cos 2 pi r by 3, I sin 2 pi r by 3. Using Bimawa theorem. Using Bimawa when r equal to 0, z equal to cos 0 plus I sin 0, 1 plus I into 0 equal to 1. When r equal to 1, z equal to cos 2 pi by 3 plus I sin 2 pi by 3. Cos 2 pi by 3 means cos 120 is equal to minus 1 by 2 I root 3 by. When r equal to 2, z equal to cos 4 pi by 3 plus I sin 4 pi by. So it can be written as cos pi plus pi by 3 I sin pi plus. It lies in the third quadrant, so both value will be negative. Cos pi by 3 is minus 1 by 2 minus I root 3 by. Tomorrow, I will solve the numerical problems. In the last, I am solving the question sent by Prasad. Maybe question is like this. If A and B are disjoint sets and N A union B equals to NA, then what will be the value of NB? Wait, I'm seeing the question. Well, there is a question. Then what must be true? What must be true about B? But I'm seeing here, A and B are disjoint, so that figure will be like this. Given that and A and B are disjoint, so that set B must be empty. Set B must be empty. But this is the answer. Another one is, if mod x equal to 3, or minus 3, what are the possible values of x? Give reason. But see here. There is no real number whose modulus will be negative. You must have studied in your class the value of modulus of any real number is always positive. The possible value means here, what is possible here? Mod x equal to x, x is greater than equal to 0, minus x when x is less than 0. When we take this value x, it will be minus 3. The possible value is that minus 3 and 3, are 3 and minus 3, but does not satisfy. The given condition. There is no real number with modulus A negative. Thank you for your question. I hope like this. All of you must send the questions in my WhatsApp number. After completing this exercise, I like to devise the derivative. I like to devise the derivative. Thank you. I will present tomorrow at this time. Yesterday, I cannot conduct my live class due to some technical reason. Thank you.